So I'm going to show you the chod rig now. It's become very popular in the last probably, I don't know, 6 years. I think I've used it for about 8 years, and yeah, I couldn't imagine carp fishing without having a chod rig in my armory now. But saying that, you know, it's not the be all and end all, and it's certainly at times it's not the best rig to use. And I think knowing when to use a choddy is key to sort of getting the most from it. They're designed to fish in chod, which chod is mucky weed, dirty bottoms, and obviously they suit that because it's a pop-up and it's going to sit on top of the bottom, so the presentation's good. I would also say they're very good when you're fishing over a scattering of boilies, when you're spreading the bait quite widely and the fish are moving around, and these rigs seem to pick them up as well. Or the amount of fish I've caught as a single, just literally seen a fish jump and I've cast out a chod rig. And the reason I've cast it out is because I don't know what the bottom's like. All I've seen is the fish jump. It might be really thick weed, heavy silt, it might be hard gravel, but I just want to get a bait in that area, and a chod rig's really good for that because we fish them on leaders. You can use lead core, you can have them straight on your main line. Some people like them on fluorocarbon, but basically this is fished helicopter style, so your lead will enter the water and the chod rig will come down very nice and slowly and sit on anything. So I'll just show you in the water how it sits. So sits nicely. I've not got a leader on that, just wanted to show you the rig in itself. And that's how it's going to sit on the bottom. It's quite a blatant rig, and I think on some day ticket lakes it's too blatant, and I prefer my baits to actually be balanced on the bottom. I'm sure that they can clear everything out and leave that, but in the right situation, like seeing a fish jump or fishing over boilies, it's fantastic. The main job though, I think it's brilliant on weedy lakes, and you can fish that into really thick weed. Your lead will bury in the weed and that will just come down and sit right on top of it. And last spring I caught my biggest fish out of the lake we're sitting on now, Spitfire, on a chod rig, 48 pound out of the weed on that rig, and that was a fish I had trouble getting to feed on the clean areas. So brilliant rig, it does pick up big fish. I like to curve mine. You can see that's curved. Again, that's the angle I want the hook to be at. I don't want the hook to be sitting upright, because you'll tend to just prick those fish in the outside of their mouths. I want the hook to go in into the mouth, the curve follows in, and as they eject the bait, the hook nails them. A nice sharp straight pointed hook, and the boilie's obviously on a D, so you get the separation. The other thing that's important, in my experience, is to fish the chod rig on a slack line, very slack. And that's not just because I don't want to spook fish, it's because the fish, when they prick themselves, they've got nothing at all to get rid of the hook. So they come up in the water, you get funny takes, really funny takes, and they're trying to get rid of the hook, but all they've got is slack line. If you give them a tight line, then they'll prick themselves, they've got a tight line then to shake that hook out. So really slack line with a chod rig. It's why it suits fluorocarbon or lead core. But yeah, it's a great rig, but like I say, you've got to pick your time to use this rig. And if you've got a very weedy lake, ideal. If you want to just fish over a scattering of boilies, ideal. A single, ideal. If you're fishing PVA bags, spod mix, then I don't think it's the right rig at all in that situation. But another thing, you've got to have a nice buoyant pop-up with it. So use an air ball, use something that's really buoyant. Learn to tie them on properly. I've got some yellow floss on that one, so it doesn't stand out. But yeah, brilliant rig. Take a little bit of practice to tie, but you know, after 10 or so, you can tie them up very quickly. And yeah, they're going to catch a lot of fish in the right situations.